I'm Erin Kyle, Editor-in-Chief of the AORN Guidelines for Perioperative Practice. I want to introduce you to the new AORN Guideline for Implementation of Enhanced Recovery After Surgery. Enhanced Recovery After Surgery, sometimes referred to as ERAS, is an interdisciplinary approach to patient care that involves the implementation of procedure-specific evidence-based protocols to enhance the patient's physiological and psychological condition before, during, and after surgery. Research shows that the synergistic effects of a comprehensive ERAS program works to improve patient outcomes while also decreasing facility costs. AORN's new guideline for implementation of ERAS includes evidence-based recommendations to help you plan, implement, and maintain an effective ERAS program for all surgical settings, including ambulatory surgery. The success of ERAS programs hinges on the effectiveness of the interdisciplinary team and including a dedicated ERAS nurse coordinator in your program. Having the right disciplines on this core team and this dedicated coordinator is essential. The nurse coordinator is a pivotal figure who works to support your interdisciplinary team by coordinating implementation, monitoring program quality, and serving as a patient liaison. The guideline includes a table that outlines recommended implementation strategies that were found in the literature as being supportive of successful programs. This table lists phase-specific actions to take and examples that can make you successful. The surgical optimization phase of care begins with performing patient assessments that identify patient-specific risk factors. The guideline includes a list of validated risk assessment tools and interventions intended to ensure each patient is best prepared, physically and emotionally, for their surgery. The immediate preoperative phase is a busy time for patients who are included in ERAS programs. During this phase, patients have a reduced time of fasting, and some receive oral carbohydrate-containing clear liquids. Patients are assessed for risk of postoperative nausea and vomiting, risk of venous thromboembolism, and risk for bleeding, and interventions for these risks are initiated. This is also when some elements of the surgical site infection prevention bundle are initiated, patient warming begins, and collaborative planning for multimodal pain management with the interdisciplinary team happens. During the intraoperative phase of care, the team works together to maintain normothermia, intraoperative fluid balance, and implement measures planned for multimodal pain management. During the postoperative phase, catheters are removed as early as possible, and patients are encouraged to move, eat, and drink as soon as they can. The guideline includes considerations for both older adult patients and children, who can both benefit significantly from the principles of ERAS. ERAS program implementation can ultimately help your team achieve optimal patient outcomes and can even support your efforts to reduce health disparities. This comes as a result of the standardization of patient care that is characteristic of ERAS programs. Our patients rely on us in their most vulnerable moments, and we can be confident knowing that we are giving them their best opportunity for the best outcome when we work together as a team. Implementing ERAS programs using a structured and coordinated approach described in this new guideline can bring us together in a way that allows us to support one another and really do our best for them.